This morning, I'm joined by Kevin Morris, a.k.a. Henry Armstrong, former professional fighter, now boxing coach. Kevin, how are you doing this morning, mate? Good to see
you. I'm going fine and dandy.
Looking forward to the fight tonight.
I certainly am.
Now, you're a bit old in the tooth. You've seen it all before, these big fights, and you know, you've been to these big fights and stayed up all night to watch them, you know. But is this one up there with it? Is this one getting you excited as a big fan?
Oh, really excited. Really excited. I'm really looking forward to it because it's a really good matchup. Two fantastic boxers, both with great styles. You know, one arguably the best pound for pound fighter on the planet. And well, for me, I think Billy Joe, he's one of those boxers, great skills. If boxing was a chess game, Billy Saunders would have all the chess pieces. That's why for me it makes it so exciting.
You know, what kind of chance are you giving Billy Joe? You know, a lot of people are writing him off. He is going in against the pound for pound number one. So, you know, he's stacked against him. But let's not forget, he is a world champion. It's a unification fight. You know, he's unbeaten. He's a southpaw. He's got a reach advantage. He's got a height advantage. You know, are we writing him off? Are people writing him off at this peril, you know?
I think so, yeah. Because I know Canelo has attained a lot of support. He's grabbed a lot of attention. He's fought a lot of great boxers. And I think what a lot of people have disregarded is the skills of Billy himself, the toughness that Billy has himself. So, you know, for me, it's a real 50-50 fight. I believe it's a 50-50 fight.
You're well informed to tell me this, Kev. You know, a former professional fighter. Before that, he was a former world champion and British and world champion kickboxer as well. Let's not forget that. And now you're a coach as well. If you had Billy Joe under your stewardship at the moment, and you was there with him in the corner in Dallas tonight, and obviously in camp with him, how would you have prepared him for this, physically, mentally, and importantly, tactically as well, going in against Canelo? I mean, knowing what you know about Canelo.
Yeah, I think he's got to stay on his feet. There's going to be stages in this fight, where he's going to have to hold his ground. But what he mustn't do is go into parallel and just stay there. That's one thing I've noticed a lot of Canelo's opponents doing. And for him, that's like putting Canelo in a sweet shot, because he'll start letting his left hand go, turning that hook, he'll twist in that uppercut, he'll sling in them two body shots if you stay there. I think a great fight to know as regards to how to get through to Canelo when using parallelism. Looking at, you know, when Liam Smith fought him, the early stages of that fight, Liam was doing a good job on Canelo, you know, using some great skills, putting his guard down, slipping in the hook, slipping his shots up the middle. So, you know, I think that sort of fight, that sort of approach in close range is what Billy wants to be looking at. And the way as Randy Lara fought him on the back foot, popping away at his jab, putting in slip combinations, not staying on the ropes, dipping, twisting around him, not allowing Canelo to settle his feet and let his shots off. That sort of gameplay in the fight would probably stand Billy in good stead, you know, which whether they can keep it up for 12 rounds, because I know Canelo now is greatly improved. Since he fought Mayweather, he learned a lot from that fight. And watching him fight bigger opponents, for example, Liam's brother. I thought Liam's brother would have had a better chance. I thought he should have approached the fight a bit differently. But the way in which he was cutting off corners, the way Canelo was cutting off corners, same way he did with Kulev, bigger lads, bigger reach, but he was fantastic at getting inside their shots and unloading his own artillery. But I think in Billy Saunders, it's a different kettle of fish that he's going to be facing. You know what I mean? I think Billy's a lot more skilled than what people give him credit for. He really, really is. And now he's fighting the fight of his life. This is why, I just can't wait till tonight.
No, it's interesting you said that with Liam Smith fight. I mean, Amir Khan was outboxing him for a while. Lara showed me a way you can, pick up points against him.
Yeah.
Kovalev as well. He was Canelo was he lost the first few rounds. You could even say he was very patient, you know. I mean, I mentioned there about Billy Joel's height and his reach. You know, he's not. That's not necessarily going to be, when you look at who he's fought, Canelo, it is going to come down to his boxing skills, isn't it? And his game plan and sticking to it for 12 rounds
Absolutely.
Performing on the night at whatever time that first bell goes, it's who performs at that moment as well, isn't it?
Yeah. I think, Billy's going to have to be the most disciplined he's ever been. In any of his fights, he's got to be as patient as he's ever been in any of his fights. He's got to have his dancing shoes on, get his way around that ring, not be scared in tying Canelo up. Again, reflecting back to the Amir Khan fight, I think when Amir fought Canelo, my first impression of that fight was Amir ain't got no chance. I've got a big thing when smaller fighters come up to fight bigger fighters. If you don't contain and hold a certain amount of strength, that you can carry up to the higher weight. Really, if you're ramping with the bigger boys have the opportunities to just blow you away. Just sit on the chances. And when Canelo dropped over and right on Amir, I could see that coming from the round before. You know what I mean? He was just setting it up. And then wallop, one shot, fight done. I don't think he can do that to Billy Saunders. You know what I mean? I don't think he's going to be able to apply that same kind of tactic to Billy Joe. If he's going to beat Billy Joe, I think it's going to be via targeting Billy's body. You know what I mean? Ripping into his body the way that he does and hurting Billy that way, you know. But outside of that, if Billy stays in his toes, he's not shy in tying him up. What I'm hoping Billy doesn't do is start getting proud, you know, and going to a toe-to-toe with him. If he does that, then, I'll just switch to telly. I don't know what will happen. Probably get sparked.
Yeah, it's good to have a big time boxing. A lot of people, 70,000 people apparently in there.
Yeah, because they helped the crowd, didn't they?
That's going to be interesting to see, you know, and boxing.
Isn't it? Fantastic, that. Well. Yeah. It just shows how much we've turned a corner now, you know, with all this coronavirus and COVID-19 stuff going on in the world today. Now getting the big events on, so that's really, really good to see. Unfortunately, you know, time hasn't worked in a way whereby Billy and the UK fans can get ourselves over there and support our soldier. But I'll be watching. You know, I know him pretty well, knowing he's like that. You know, he's got the country behind him. He's got a very, very hard task ahead, but hopefully he'll come through, pull through and have his hands raised as the victor.
And if he does have his hands raised, how's he going to do it, Kev, in your opinion? How does it go? Are you picking him to win? Are you picking him to win if if it was putting it on the line now and you had to choose one with your boxing head ruling your heart, how's it going to go?
With my boxing head, what I'm asking Billy to do is a heck of a lot against somebody like Canelo. My boxing head does lean slightly more to Canelo, but my heart, it leans all the way to Billy, you know. But hopefully he'll pull through, he'll apply the skills that he does possess. He'll irritate Canelo. Force Canelo to get sloppy, force Canelo to get, lapsing his skills, you know. Force Canelo to get frustrated and hopefully work on that. Make him make mistakes.
You'll be staying up or setting the alarm or what?
Setting the alarm, me. Damn, stay up days are over. Yeah. I mean, the problem with staying up is the fridge. Say again.
So we're getting too old for that now, eh?
Yeah, isn't it? No. When I stay up, man, it's all about the fridge light. No, you stay up, then stupid hours, you find yourself wandering into the fridge, eating just random stuff. So, nah. I'd rather be unconscious, apply modern gadgets such as alarms and deal with the fact that way.
we go back a few years, Kev. I always enjoy speaking about boxing with you. Appreciate your opinion. Got to have you on here regularly doing these now. And when the big fights are coming up or any fights, you'll get your opinion. And I'm sure other people.
If you will, that'd be nice.
Well, how are you anyway? What are you up to? Just tell us briefly what you're up to at the moment. And I'll tell you what, I'll put a link on. We did a video a while back about your career in boxing and all that. I'll put a link on so people get to know who you are. What you did in your career. And but what you're up to at the moment, just tell us briefly, you're coaching still, you're out over at the gym in Salford with Gary.
Yeah, Salford City Boxing Academy. Yeah, I'm over there. Now currently training the competition squad. So we've got a group of amateur boxers. We've got a couple that we're looking at turning over pro. exciting prospects. Hopefully that will fall into fruition later on this year, early next year. But it's dealing with boxers when they get into that transition stage. They get into 15, 16, 17, some of the senior amateur members. I've been schooling them, taking them through the paces recently. So hopefully we'll have the team out soon when the show's show volume increases. Have the lads out there doing their thing.
Brilliant, brilliant. Well, I'll get over and see you soon if you've got anyone
to. Yeah, do come over up.
And we'll give them some support.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, I'll give you a bell next week when we'll
punk. Yeah, definitely. Get yourself
talk about the fight. What happened?
Well, Kev,
have a great day. Great to see you. I'll see you soon.
No, I will. See you soon.
Best, mate.
All right, mate. All the best.